Alright guys, what's going on? Excuse my jump. It kind of seems to get piled up out there. Yep, 572 gassed up and oiled up. I wasn't going to do it, but I want to run it and see how it does. I at least want to start it up before I send it to Cajun. And I made this video kind of last night, but when it came in, but I didn't have it full of gas and oil, and I want to weigh it full of gas and oil. It's fairly close. It was a little lighter than the Makita and the 5-Rod when I weighed it, but of course it didn't have no gas or oil in it. So now that it's full, I want to weigh it real, you know, I want to weigh it. I guess I could weigh it real quick before I even start it. I want to turn my oil up too. I'll flip y'all around here to the scales, and I know they're twisted, but you'll just have to take my word for it. Of course, it's got the Canon Duralight bar on it. That's going to add like 0.30. Not quite a half pound, but it's going to add that to the saw. It's got a 28-inch bar, just like the Makita and all that had on it. Full wrap, West Coast Dogs. Weighs in at 2202. So, let's see what the 500i weighs. It's still full of gas, no, I ain't run it, none. So 2202. So you take 0.3 off of that. That would really weigh 2170 with a steel light bar on it. $21.50, $52, $21.48. It's bouncing in between, it's swinging. 2148. Full rat and everything. 2148. And this is, yeah, like 22 even is what it's swinging right now. No, it ain't swinging. So you'd be like 2170. So it's a little heavier than 500i. Not much. Of course, it's down on power by a few cc's. I've got hooked up. So anyway, I'm gonna take the Makita. I'm gonna take the Makita and the 572 out to the wood pile. I'll set y'all out here, and I'll be right back real quick. I've already got the West Coast Dogs full wrap panels on them. I do like Husky because their full wraps are cheaper and everything. Than even per se, like even them Makita. So let me grab the saws, I'll be back. I'll say just packing these, I don't know if it's balance or what it is, but the 572 feels, honestly feels lighter. It feels good. Husky's got very good anti-vibe, and the way that they have their weight balanced is really good. It seems like and the way they got their handlebars and everything, it just don't seem like the weights all up here. And it could be where they're a little heavier. But I haven't never started this, and I ordered this, of course, on the web. And normally at the dealership, you know, they start the saws up for you. So I hope this thing starts and runs. I don't know. I don't normally push the decomp. We'll see it on this one.
And Huskies to me have better oilers than Steel does. I've never had much had a problem with Husky oiling a bigger bar, but Steel sometimes, yeah. So I didn't get a chance to run it either. And yes, I've ran them before and everything, but I just still haven't got to run it. I don't even know if I got the tune right on this thing, you know. I messed with it a little bit. I will say that the skip, I got skip on that 572 right now. It don't cut as good as what the full, they got the whole form of skip on it. Because it'll run on these saws, you know. It might have been the West Coast covers on the steels wasn't letting that skip run on it. So, yeah, I may start running a little bit of that on some bigger stuff. I don't know. We'll see. You know, it's just one deal. I got a lot of saws, new saws. Got a lot of new saws to break in. And they're not going to run to their potential until I get some time on them. So, which I've got plenty of tree work coming up and stuff, so I should get to running some. But the Makita, I wanted not so much just because of running and everything, just because they're not making. Before long, them's going to be hard to find. You know, it might be several years before they're all bought up, but once they're bought up, they're not going to be very, you know. And they're a good saw, and they're good for the money, so, you know. They have some hell yeah compression and everything, so better choke it. And they run to me about like a steel. broke this fast tack or something. Way fat, it's only turning like 11,000 RPM, and which I can tell it's fat. And I've got to turn about 12 now. I turned it up to 12.3. I think the register 12.5 is what the coil is set for, or whatever. But I run them a little fatter for the first little bit anyway, just because, you know, sometimes I'm not as good about warming up solid as what I should be, but it, you know, it cuts good. It cut good at 11, you know, not. Yeah, that's pretty smooth. Not terribly bad smooth, and it cuts fairly good. It's a little smoother than the steel, and not as smooth as a Husky for sure. As them new Huskies, man. I know they got a little give from what people want. We'll see if this fires back up real quick. After it's set here. So I know some people don't like the flaky sauce, and at some points I'm not crazy about them, but these Huskies right here, you don't feel any vibration in your hand. Caden said he was ready for me to send them, and I'm ready to send them. But I wasn't gonna put gas in the 572. I thought he might be a little further out, which I didn't know when the sauce was gonna come in either, because I ordered them, and of course you get dates and everything. But when the baffle comes out of that, those have baffles in them. Like you say, they have a big honking square thing that restricts flow. When that thing comes out and everything, that'll be just, even that makes it a totally different saw. It's a little more snappier on the throttle, the best I can remember. And the Husky 572 series, sorry for shaking all around, 500 series, I talked to Aaron about it, or with Aaron about it a little bit and everything, and I've talked with other guys, and I've let some guys run my saws, and all in all, they're good saws and everything, but they seem to be, they're very, they seem like they scream as far as RPM goes, they're revving to the moon, but they a little lackluster when it comes to torque. But all in all, that 572 ain't a bad saw. I remember bashing it, and that's just my memory. I guess my memory was playing tricks on me. Talking about they were turd saws, I wouldn't necessarily say they're a turd saw. That saw really ain't gonna be that far behind the 500, a stock 500i or that Makita, honestly. It's not gonna be as quick or as stout. But they're not gonna just walk off and leave it. And honestly, it's not that much heavier, if any. And it's not bad on balance. It's balanced really well. Like, honestly, if I was gonna have to pick a saw, and I'm gonna probably kick my own ass for saying this, if I was gonna have to pick a saw to run all day, then I probably would pick that 572, honestly, because it's just probably the most comfortable. And then, I don't know. Depending on what I'm doing, I guess. Sorry for beating y'all around. Sit with me. Since I got y'all out and I've got a little daylight. I ran one tank through this cheapest saw on Amazon and tightened the chain up and everything. And I want to run it again now that I got on camera, because I lost my last footage. And plus, if I keep on playing with this wood right here before long, all I'll have is sawdust to scrape up and clean up. So it's on, let's choke it. It's got the easy start. Not terrible, it's set for about a week. like say the chain could use attention, and you got to remember all this wood was about half dead when I cut it,
and it's been sitting here for, it's been cut since way back in the summer last year, so it's very, very dry. So it's, you know,
honestly, I mean, it's not bad heavy. I like this little saw. To me, it's for $100, if you had a crew or something and you just needed a cheap lemon saw, I don't know about maybe a crew doing tree work.
For me, like just doing the part-time deal or whatever, if I have to limb anything or cut some nasty crap or take one up in a tree and you're worried about dropping it, or getting hung up or whatever, that'd be the saw to do, for real. Anyway, I made this one long enough. I've touched on a little bit of everything what I want to touch on, and everything. So y'all have a good one. I'll catch you on the next one.